Oh, I love Blackpool. Little stick of Blackpool rock. Get that on George Formby, don't you? My little stick of Blackpool rock.
Family's been out here running the donkey ride since 1886. We've been here, so we're a long-established family, and we've seen a lot of changes over the years.
We're great beach people, but not sunbathing. The bottom line is we never sunbathe.
The wind, if it's too strong, it's not so comfortable. You know, a bit cool. But today I found quite pleasant, to be quite honest. Yes, rather warmer than yesterday, I thought.
I think you just take potluck, don't you?
A little bit of a joke, isn't it?
If it rains, then we've got wet weather gear, so it doesn't really stop us.
When it does rain, it clears the beach. As soon as you get some rain, there can be thousands of people along the beach. As soon as you get a drop of that rain, they're gone.
Donkey rides and dodging cars and candy floss, toffee apples, they're the things that you sort of associate with a British seaside resort, you know.
Yeah, indeed. My wife and I holiday annually in Cornwall or Devon. My wife actually must have sea and coast on her holiday agenda, so that over the many years, even though all our holidays have been in Britain, we've only once been to a non-coastal county, which is Shropshire. We had a fine holiday there, but the need to be near the sea nevertheless draws us back time and time again.
I think the favourite beach that I do is right up there where you can see the cliffs at Scarborough, where the donkey ride. It's on the south side, on the north side. I think that's the nicest part, and Bridlington Beach. But I think the Scarborough Beach is the nicest one that I've ever been to.
Yes, I think we've got a lovely beach. The only problem is obviously the sea doesn't come in very often. Usually it's only in twice a day, and it usually seems to be the wrong time of the day for holiday makers.
What I love is just splashing in the waves, and it's really cold, and you just jump in the sea, swim around in there, and it's just really nice.
Oh no, I wouldn't do that. No, too many germs in the sea, too many things that can make you ill and bad. Well, no, if you want to stay healthy, stay out of the sea. That's what I say.
I'm not very good at swimming. I just sink. Don't know why that is. I do, though. It's true, because people say if you lie on your back, you float. Well, you don't. Well, I don't. I just sink.
I do like swimming in the sea. I've always done it. We used to go to Cornwall, it was nice, but it was always windy, always cold. Whereas I find in this area, we always feel, you know, much, much better. I wouldn't mind living down there, to be quite honest.
I had octopus once when we were... I didn't know it was octopus, mine.
Very tough, isn't it?
Yes.
Very tough, yes.
But I ate it. Tricky. I'm saying now that I won't eat prawns
very
and all these
chewy,
things, but
chewy.
I ate that.
Yeah.
But when I knew afterwards, like everybody else, I felt quite ill. Mm.
In our own part of the world, we're extremely attached to Whitby, and visited in what's called our Whitby season, which is from October to March.
I've always felt uncomfortable with hot weather. I don't like hot weather. I don't like it. So, and you don't either.
No,
do you?
I can't.
So we're agreed on that.
I love sunbathing because it's very warm and it's very relaxing, and it's almost like just being in bed, really, isn't it? Except it's like having a big electric blanket over you all the time, and you go brown, and that's always good.
I can't sunbathe for very long because I had a very hot summer. I got sunstroke, and I can't sit out in it too long. I can sit for so long, I sit for an hour, put some plenty of cream on, but after that I start feeling sickly and I've got to come in.
At the end of the day, what's it doing? It's cooking you, isn't it? The sun is actually cooking you.
Plus,
that's
I get
why
heat
you go
rash.
Brown.
If I'm in it for 10 minutes, I get a heat rash.
No, don't want to burn my skin, do I? Bad for you.
I love scrambling over rocks, being in the rock pools, and just looking for crabs and looking for mussels.
Oh, the best place for rock pooling is definitely Sidmouth. Really, really, really lovely rock pools everywhere. And I was rock pooling with all the little kids, and I was sort of digging around with, like, marvelling at nature. Oh, this disgusting thing, this turd fish, and it comes really slovenly, and I pulled it up, and I was trying to sort of marvel at it with the children. It was so disgusting. I just ended up screaming and chucking it back.
Well, you notice pollution. I think they're a lot cleaner than they used to be, the beaches in this country. They're beginning to clean, get their act together, I think, now. Well, I have to, don't know, there's the European regulations on beaches.
Well, the one what springs to my mind, it was a very, very big spillage.
Worst fear, I suppose, isn't it? If you dive in and you dive in.
Yeah. You don't want to go in the water and come up with, like, oil all over you.
Yeah.
It must put people off for holiday to see the state of it.
I think they get fined. I'm almost certain they do get fined, the ship owners.
Pollution is a problem everywhere, isn't it? I don't know. On the beach, what do you get? What pollution do you get on the beach? You get, well, too many people, probably, is the worst pollution, and their radios.
We wouldn't sit next to someone that had radios blaring out and were really being loud and everything. I think if they came and sat next to us, we'd move. If we were sitting on the beach, or if they had dogs or stuff like that, we wouldn't stay there.
The only reason I'm still doing this job is because of the children. If you see their faces as they get off a coach, remember, some have never seen a beach before, and it gives us great pleasure. The children are what make the job.
The old stuff, the donkeys and the carts and things like that, they're going to be around for a long time to come, yeah. The high-tech games, I think, really, they've had their day.
So, coming back tomorrow, and hopefully swim again, all being well. I don't know what the forecast is for tomorrow, but if it's like this, we should be here. OK. Right. Not to speak to you anyway.
As to the finest holiday that I've had, I would probably say, paradoxically, that it was in the Lake District during the foot and mouth epidemic.
My ideal British holiday, I'd probably like a weekend city break myself, living by the sea.
Don't mind if I hit this, dear.